welcome to Tokyo Disney Resort with Tokyo Disney Dad. Today we will be visiting my favorite park, Tokyo Disney Sea. Tokyo Disney Sea first opened on September 4th, 2001 and is celebrating its 20th anniversary this year. The easiest way over to Tokyo Disney Sea is by the monorail system, unless you're coming by car and then you can park in the parking lots. However, Japan's monorail system works slightly different. You have to pay for it due to public transportation laws here, and that's the same reason why there isn't a looping train railroad in Tokyo Disney Park. Tokyo Disney's monorail system has four stops. There's the Resort Gateway Station, the Tokyo Disneyland Station, Bayside Station, and the Tokyo Disney Sea Station. The Tokyo Disneyland Station is where Tokyo Disneyland is located. Bayside Station is where all the partner hotels are located, and in Tokyo Disney Sea is where Disney Sea is, and then the Resort Gateway is the main station for the monorail system. Here you see some pictures of some of the details from the history of the monorail. As you can see, our monorail has Mickey windows, and it even becomes even more elaborate inside. And depending on the seasonal overlays, the inside will match the monorail system itself. However, currently there aren't seasonal or attraction overlays due to the restrictions it being enforced, but that's okay. Our monorail is quite fancy inside. I love that they have the Mickey windows, the Mickey handhold, so if you're standing, things like that, the Mickey seats, it's all themed. It's a very beautiful monorail. As you can see here, you buy a ticket, and a one-way ticket, or just a ticket, is 260 yen for adults, 130 yen for children. However, you can buy one-day passes and ride it as much as you want, two-day passes. If you stay in a hotel, you might get a special version of the cards, and that was the 20th anniversary. And it's just really nice to ride around. I could ride around on it all day long, just the monorail itself. Something else that's really cool about our monorail is there isn't a driver. The whole system is automated. I think that's why we don't have as many accidents as the monorails down in Florida. There is no driver, and the doors open automatically. When they get to the station, it stops automatically. It's all automated. So at the front of Tokyo Disney Sea is the Aquasphere. It's not our park icon. That's actually Mount Prometheus. Now, Tokyo Disney Sea does have Toy Story and Mania. It's located in American Waterfront. It's the only Pixar-related attraction in this park. Our Toy Story and Mania is really beautiful at night.
Inside of Toy Story Mania. Of course, you know we're under Andy's bed when we go riding and shooting the game. Here's Andy. You know, here's a funny thing. But that's crayon. Kids nowadays grow up wanting iPhones, iPads, all that. But all I ever wanted Christmas, and my mom did her best to get it to me. It was a 64 pack of that of Crayola crayons with a sharpener in it. So mom, thanks for the Crayola crayons.
Next to Toy Story Mini and American Waterfront is Hightower Hotel. It's our version of Tower of Terror and owned by Harrison Hightower. Harrison Hightower is, of course, a member of the Society of Explorers and Adventurers, which is a prominent theme within Tokyo DisneySea itself. Joe Rohde, the Imagineer that designed the attraction, is featured as Harrison Hightower within pictures within the attraction. And also, he was originally the portrayed Harrison Hightower in the original Tower of Terror commercial for Japanese TV. Mount Prometheus is actually the centerpiece of the park and the park icon itself. Within Mount Prometheus is Mysterious Island. Now, Mysterious Island is where there are two main attractions, one of my favorite, which is Journey to the Center of the Earth, and also the reimagined 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea. As you leave Mysterious Island, you see Mermaid Lagoon for the very first time. Mermaid Lagoon is just an inside, full of kids' rides. It's great for the kids. It's beautiful at night. As you pass by Mermaid Lagoon, you actually begin to see Arabian Coast. Arabian Coast has several attractions, including a Magic Lamp Theater, a two-story merry-go-round, and one of the best attractions in the park, which is Sinbad's Storybook Journey. There is also Abu's Bazaar. And at Abu's Bazaar, you can play a game. It's 700 yen, about $7 to play once. And if you win, you get a figurine. And if you lose, you get a pin. Now, my preference is to actually lose because I'm a pin collector. And also, I don't want to carry the big figurine around the park all day long.
ありがとうございます。So I lost, but I get to come over here and get a pin. So I'm happy with that.
Just outside of Abu's Bazaar is Sinbad's Storybook Voyage. It's probably one of the best dark rides in any park in the world. It's a great little dark ride, even though Sinbad doesn't really have a Disney movie. The attraction fits well into Disney Sea, considering Sinbad was an explorer, and that fits into the Society of Explorers and Adventurers, even though that was established well after Sinbad's time. The ride itself was refurbished in 2007 to become what it is today, and the newer version is a much more popular version, and it's mainly due to the theme song, which is a theme song by Alan Menken called Compass of Your Heart. Let's take a ride with Sinbad and just enjoy the attraction.
ありがとうございます。
为了安全起见，航行时请勿站立，或将头手伸出船外。此外，请勿使用闪光灯拍照。
安全のため、航行中は立ち上がったり、手や顔を外に出さないようお願いします。 楽器で乱暴者の猿たちをなだめるのじゃ。
一緒に演奏しよう。きっと戻ってくるからね。
Tokyo DisneySea takes advantage of its water theme and actually uses a boat system instead of a train system to get around the park. And it offers some of the best views of the theming in the park.
しみください。
リバーデルタを後にして、これから向かうのはアラビアンコースト。千夜一夜物語を思わせるエキゾチックな世界です。
お楽しみいただけます。
Back in American Waterfront, Scrooge McDuck's department store is where you can find all the Duffy and Friends goods. There and Aunt Polly's are the only two places in the park that has everything Duffy and Friends. Also in American Waterfront, it offers the Big Band Beat show. It's one of the better shows in any park in the world. Although this current version is really restricted, doesn't have the live musicians like it used to, so it's not as good. However, it's still a lottery ticket system, and on this day, I actually happened to win, and I enjoyed the show.
Gondolas again. Started here this morning, but didn't. We were first in line, very first, but they told us we couldn't live stream, so I won it. So I moved off, just out of respect. And now we're going to try it again. There we go. Actually, it's kind of more beautiful in the evening anyway.
Venetian gondolas are actually quite popular within the park, and today I enjoyed a ride, although I'm going to give you the sped up version. So let's take a ride on a Venetian gondola out into the Mediterranean harbor with some of the best views of Mount Prometheus.
Jump on.
Mm-hmm.
journey to the center of the earth in the middle of Mysterious Island uses a test track drive system, and it has one of the biggest and best audio animatronics in the world with the Lava Monster. Not to be missed if you ever come to this place. As night falls, that's when the true beauty of DisneySea comes out. It's like a whole nother park, a whole different park from what you've been seeing all day long. And the beauty of it is incredible. The colors, the lights, just the romance of it. It's a park that should be on everybody's bucket list.
Nighttime view of Indiana Jones.
Thank you for watching this pre-recorded stream or vlog of Tokyo DisneySea. I hope you enjoyed the day out there with me. I was not able to show everything in that wonderful, amazing themed park. It would take a lot of video footage to show everything. It's something that everybody should put on their list, a bucket list, and come out and see. My opinion, and a lot of people's opinion, it is the best Disney park in the world, especially for theming. But anyway, the reason why I did this pre-recorded vlog was for Moffitt Cancer Research 24-hour live stream. So if you watch me prior to this and I was live in land, I just wanted to bring you a little bit of DisneySea also, but I can't be in two places at one time on the same day. So if you watched all of it, I appreciate it. If you haven't donated yet to the cause of cancer research, finding a treatment, finding a cure, all those things are really important to me and friends of mine, family of mine, and a lot of people in this world are affected by that monster we call cancer. But you know, I don't want to finish on that kind of depressing note. I'd rather finish up positive and say, you know, DisneySea, it's wonderful. Come see it. I'll be your tour guide, guaranteed. And I'll finish it up. If you're watching this in replay, I will put a link in the description of my video so that you can always donate, whether that's 1 day from now, 5 days from now, a year from now, whatever. You know, every little bit will help. If not, if you can't donate, sharing it out. Sharing it with friends, and that's just as good. You know, we'll get there. But I'll finish it up by turning it over to whoever's next. I don't know, but that's okay. And I will finish up with me saying, be kind, be positive, be you. And I'll see you again on my channel, Tokyo Disney Dad. If you want to see Tokyo content, look me up, find me, and I'll be there. See you next time.